Then we have the tandwiel.
Moet ik nog op een knopje drukken?
Voor het scherm?
Kabel zit in?
Ja.
Voilà. Ah,
kijk eens aan. User agent.
Okay.
Please come in. Come a bit to the front. Great. For the people in the back, can you hear me? Good? You don't want to come up close, up the front? No? Fine. And then put it in full screen. First of all, welcome all to my session about spatial Drupal. Yes, please come in and come sit nearby so I can see you good. It's in the left room, the auditorium, at the Drupal Camp Ghent. And it's not in full screen yet. So I need to kill. Ah, it's this one. That's much better. Welcome. Please be seated a little bit in the front so I have a nice cozy atmosphere. Thank you. Hi, I'm Floris, and I call myself a Drupal entrepreneur, which means that I work about 60% for clients to keep my chimney smoking and pay for my people, and the other 40% I do product development. You can find me on Twitter at 040lab and on IRC at Zelfje, which is a little fairy from a very ancient story from the Netherlands, from Ellie and Rickert. And Zelfje is fighting all the systems in order to be not caught by the systems and not controlled by the systems. So that's why my IRC handle is Zelfje. Today I'm going to talk to you about how to use Drupal in a different context for content. So not the images, the texts, and the videos that we're used to, but to use different kinds of content in your content management system. It will consist of four parts, and the first part will be about mapping GIS. Yesterday we've seen a great presentation about how to use Cartaro, and we used Cartaro as well for this product. Then a little part about Urbania, city mapping, city engineering. Next part will be about building management. So we're actually going to manage a building with a Drupal site. It's great. And then to combine everything, how to use sensors and the Internet of Things in order to make sense out of all these data and combine and hook up all the systems together as a whole. First, we start with mapping. In the old days, the world was flat. If you would go to the edge of the world, you would actually fall off. Well, that's what they believed. And to create this picture, I made some scene.js, 3.js script. And if you click on the presentation, it will be on Ghent2016.040lab.com in the end, so you don't have to take notes or anything from the slides themselves. But if you actually click on this one, it will open the scene.js where you can rotate around this flat world. Then this guy came along in about 1569. And his name is Mercator, and he made a projection system. And with this projection system, people were able to conquer the world, to get all the wealth out of it, and to navigate and get back home safely. And we see that the world is divided in four quadrants. And see, there's a little pointer here. There. Here in the median, which goes from the center of England down south, and we have the equator. And these four quadrants determine where you are on the world in a latitude and a longitude. There's different kinds of projection systems, and I'm not going to deep dive into those, who are optimized for a certain part of the world. For example, in the Netherlands, we use RD, and that is in meters with long numbers, and it's made from all the church towers and big towers in the triangular system, and in that way we can map the Netherlands properly. And each region has its own kind of a Mercator-like mapping system. Then Google came along in 2005. So the world from flat became round, and they revolutionized it, and they made the world flat again. Wow, Google. So what they did is they made a tile 256 square of the whole world. So if you completely zoomed out, like here, then the whole world is just 256 pixels. And when you zoom in more and more and more, then you get little tiles, and with the little tiles you determine that location on the map, and you show it to your site visitors. Another thing what they did, besides the Web Mercator, is this map tile. In 2014, I got a phone call from somebody who said, oh yeah, we're doing this mapping thing, and I thought, oh nice, I've done a lot of find my nearest beer store and my nearest shop locator maps in Google Maps, so well, why not, let's look what you guys wanted to do. And then they had a sort of starter install with Cartaro, and we looked at it, and it was running on a Windows IS server. I thought, no, that's too much of a fuss. Let's change that, let's run it on a proper Linux and start developing and building from there. And now, 2 years later, we built a geospatial mapping system to keep track of glass fiber connections. So all these little flags you see here on the map are actually projects where holes are dug in the ground, and glass fiber connections are laid into the ground, and then individual houses are connected. And of course, the client of my client wants to keep track of the status. How much is dug and how much is the progress? And if you click on a certain house number, what are its details? And if you look at a specific project, then it consists of these little gutters. And with the gutters, there is connection points. And from the connection points, you have the connection to the house. So with that, we currently finished the minimal viable product 2. And we're starting on minimal viable product 3. And then I've seen some downside of Drupal. Drupal is not that well, not that good in handling files and revisioning of files. So either we're going to work with file entity and hook out and grab out all the metadata from the file in order to make some sense of this bulk bunch of files, or we're going to implement a proper DMS like Alfresco, which is also open source and targeted at handling files in a proper way. Yesterday, I got the great news from my employee that the CAS, Central Authentication Service, is working between Drupal and Drupal, and that we're able to get all the users from one Drupal and migrate them to the CAS, and then rehook up the roles, or connect, because it's a numerical field, connect the group ID of the group that the user is currently working in. So for the next step, I'm doubting to implement organic groups because there is a lot of tunnel vision. Like, you're not supposed to see anything outside your project as a subcontractor, because these fiber optic cable men, they work with as a big organization, and then you have subcontractors, and then you have the sub-subcontractor. So there is some accessibility issues that people are not supposed to access other kinds of projects. And also what I notice is that this geo component in the geo server has some performance issues. So I'm looking in a broader sense to get leaner and better geo systems in place. And of course, we need to add more cache.